Birthday Bash 22! We have a special show for a special guy because it's his special day! Happy birthday, G-Man! And we're gonna start things off here with a dream match to some, not all, of the Mustache Mountain taking on Nacho y Esqueleto for the FAW Tag Team Championships! You can hear the electricity of this crowd as the challengers make their way into the arena. It's Nacho and his sidekick, Esqueleto, as they look to gain the tag team championships, to gain the gold for the children of their orphanage. But can they go the distance? Can they climb that mountain and reach the eagle eggs? Or will they just be a couple of goofballs in the process? Look, case in point. And here come the champs. Now, if you have been paying attention, Mustache Mountain won the championships from Tyson Kidd and Cesaro after they won it from Rusev Day at Winterslam. Right at the beginning of the match, before it even started, Cesaro attacked Tyson Kidd, betrayed him, and just gave Mustache Mountain the win. But will it be that easy for Mustache Mountain to take down Nacho and Esqueleto this time around? We'll have to see and find out as this match is for all the gold, baby. Seems like Esqueleto and Tyler Bate are going to start things off here. Oh, whoa. Esqueleto is a little bit jumpy there, but Tyler Bate showing some sportsmanship, and there you go. That's a smart cookie. That's one smart guy right there in Esqueleto. As we get the lock up here, going around the ring, and now Tyler Bate using the ropes as leverage. Off, Esqueleto runs to the other side of the ring, ducks the elbow. Oh, look at this transition there by Esqueleto. He sure knows his stuff. Oh, wait a minute, Tyler Driver 98. No, wait a second, look at this. Esqueleto, like I said, he knows his stuff. Don't sleep on Esqueleto here, ladies and gentlemen. And now look at this. Oh, Tyler Bate. He seemed to be the seasoned veteran of the two here. But Esqueleto using the ropes to escape here. Now Tyler Bate, oh, whoa, look at the agility of Esqueleto here. These guys are just running round and round. Look at Esqueleto with the splash. It connects there. But look at Tyler Bate's strength. That's where the difference lies between these two gentlemen right here. Oh, and there's the body slam there. Tags in Trent Seven. Now Esqueleto might be in jeopardy here as the assisted senton commences onto the chest of the challenger. And then look at this, Tyler Bate going up high. What's he thinking of doing here? Collapses off of Trent Seven and hits the chest of Esqueleto once again. And now the challenger's hurt. Ooh! Huge chop right to the chest. There's another one as he forces him up against the post, and Nacho watching carefully here as Esqueleto is forced to run to the other side. Look at this. Oh, able to land on his feet there. And there's the arm drag by Esqueleto, and Trent Seven is sent to the other side of the ring. Look at this. Watch out there. Oh, he tried to hit the splash, missed it. And now Trent Seven, what's this? And the dragon suplex that connects right to the top of the noggin of Esqueleto. Now look at this. The people, the crowd, they want to see Nacho in this match, and Nacho notices as he's now signaling Esqueleto to tag him in. But I don't think it's going to be that easy. I don't think Trent Seven's going to let him tag him in. So there goes the backhand. No, wait a second, Esqueleto. He tags in Nacho. And it is Nacho who's going to get in the match. Nacho, people. Nacho. Oh, my God. Okay. All right. Not quite what I expected, but here we go. We're just dancing here. Now, Esqueleto trying to get his bearings back as Nacho is now front and center into this fight, but he gets the headlock driver. Oh, wait a second. Look how quickly he transitions into the head scissors. Nacho knows his stuff too, people. Oh, ducks the clothesline off the ropes. Nacho rebounding into a tilt-a-whirl head scissors by Nacho. here as Nacho becomes a locomotive and drives his back into the chest of Trent Seven. There goes the snapmare. What's he gonna do? Jumps up. Oh, he hits the drop kick in the back of the head, and we do hear the sickening slap of his feet up against the back of the head of Trent Seven. Into the ropes, or the corner, I should say, as he gets ready for the sidewalk slam, but here comes Escalento with the assist. Oh my god, the big boot to the side of the head, and now, what's this? Off the ropes, a flapjack assisted splash onto the chest of Trent Seven. Could this be it? Could we have new champions? No. Great match so far. I think it's safe to say that Nacho and Escalento are sure impressing a lot of people here tonight. This, oh, Trent Seven tried to hit something. Oh, ducks the clothesline. And there's the backhand right to the chin of Trent Seven. And then, oh my god, oh Jesus. Trent Seven might have just bitten off more than he could chew here. Wait, as Tyler Bate is checking on his partner, Nacho seems to have an idea. Oh, wait, don't tell me. Is Escalento ready to hit the poetry in motion? Much like the Hardy Boys? Are we gonna see it here? Do it, do it. What? Oh, he's too scared, people. He's too scared to make that big of a commitment in this title match, but Mustache Mountain wasting no time, taking advantage of the weakness. Oh my God! And again with the chop. Jesus, just showing no mercy to Nacho. Oh, right to the titties. And now he's forcing Nacho back inside the ring. As Trent Seven is looking to pick up the scraps here. Forcing Nacho into his own corner, trying to keep him as far away from Escalento as possible, as with the assisted powerbomb. And still not enough to take down Nacho. I'm honestly already impressed. A move like that could take down any lesser man, but this is the Eagle Warrior we're talking about. Half and half some attempt here, but Trent Seven able to get out of it, into the ropes, slides underneath the legs of Tyler Bate, almost got them confused. And there's the chop into the corner. But no, oh, wait a second. Oh, the people sense it. Just like when Nacho shocked the world at Winter Slam against the Hurricane, we are going to see the Lord's chop. Look at him go. Look at Nacho go. Oh my God, the chest of Tyler Bate has to be an absolute fuego. All she wrote, or is it, as Nacho is revving up his engine, going around the ring, but they hit the splash. No, wait a second. Look at the strength of Tyler Bate with the Saito suplex. Drills him into the mat, and look at the agility of Tyler Bate. He's feeling it now. Wait a second, standing shooting star press. He landed it perfectly, but it's still not enough to take down Nacho. Can't beat him, hit him with your best move, Tyler Driver, no. Nacho able to get out of it, pushes him off, bop. Oh my God, Nacho brought his own bang as he puts him into the ropes, right at the wheel kick right to the top of the head of Nacho as he goes tumbling to the outside. Jesus Christ, his bell has been rung all right. As Escalento goes off to check on his partner here on the outside. Wait a second, oh, he just pushed him out of the way. Trent Seven with the toe-face suicida taking down Nacho. Escalento doesn't know what's happening. And there's Tyler Bate! Jesus H. Christ! This match has defied all expectations. It is awesome indeed, as Tyler Bate looking to end it with that corkscrew splash right to the stomach of Nacho. And it's still not enough! Are you kidding me? Everyone in disbelief as this tag team title match reigns on, and you can see it in Tyler Bate's eyes. He is pretty impressed with Nacho's performance. But Trent Seven, I think he's had about enough of the Nacho train. And now look at Tyler Bate looking to end this. Oh, wait a second, what the hell? Escalento coming out from the bottom of the ring, stopping Tyler Bate. Trent Seven tries to hit the burning hammer anyway, but look at Nacho up on his feet, and there's a spinning high kick right to the top of the head. Take taken down, Trent Seven. And now Tyler Bate able to push Escaleto off of him. Look at Nacho taking advantage of the situation. Dropkick, oh my God! He just fell onto Trent Seven from about 8 feet high. Oh wait, no. What's Nacho thinking of doing here? What's Nacho thinking? Nacho's gonna fly! On top of the champions, and Nacho is feeling the eagle powers, all right. Say it again. Oh, wait a second. Oh, wait, second time's the charm, as it seems that Escaleto has no problem hitting a splash from that height. Holy shit. And there's the high five between the two Eagle Warriors. They're now looking to end it, probably, as Trent Seven is helpless. And yes, I was right with my assumption. We might be at the cusp of seeing new tag team champions. As Nacho Libre is hyping up the crowd. Now look at Escaleto. Oh my God, the strength of is pretty deceptive here. But look at Trent Seven able to escape. And oh my God, oh my God! Nacho just fell down all the way to the barricade, hitting the back of his head. And now look at Escaleto. Wait a second, no! Still fighting with all of his heart's content. But look at Tyler Bate. Oh, Escaleto gets out of the way, makes a European uppercut his own partner. Jesus Christ, that haluva kick from Escaleto rocks Tyler Bate to his very core. And there goes the chop. And there's one for Tyler Bate. Oh my God, Escaleto is just a chop salesman. He's just a one-man army here against Mustache Mountain. Oh, wait a second, Bop. Bang! Oldest trick in the book. And there's the backhanded fist by Trent Seven. And there's the big boot by Tyler Bate. Jesus Christ. They're both double teaming on this one guy. It's still just one on two. And Tyler Bate takes Escaleto's head off. That's it. The champions retain. Are you kidding me? I cannot believe my eyes and ears, ladies and gentlemen. Don't mind the pictures of Taz and Paul Heyman. Those are only there for display. It is I, the one and only Danny Meltzer, who's calling this action. That's Nacho Libre is back. Oh my God! He just pushed Tyler Bate off the top, and he goes crashing down to the floor. He has to be deceased. Escaleto escapes the burning hammer position, and now look at Escaleto, the quickness of the homeless man. Oh, misdirection. Trent Seven doesn't know what is going on here. Tries to hit that clothesline. Escaleto running there, and there's a big bump right to the side of the head. Wait a minute. Springboard by Escaleto into the cutter. That is it. Trent Seven has to be unconscious as Nacho is sensing that it might just be over. Nacho, off the top, what the hell is he thinking of doing here? What the hell? Oh my God! Doomsday Destroyer by the Challengers, and we have new tag team champions! They did it! They did it for the children! For the monastery! Nacho and Escaleto are your brand spanking new FAW World Tag Team Champions! And this is the first match of Birthday Bash 22, ladies and gentlemen!
And then I was all like, you're not my bro! And then I just kneed him in the face. And then I hit a reverse bro to sleep. Concussion City, bro. And then I just skedaddled moving around. Alright, bros, I'll be here. Jericho can't do this. Bring me an ice cream sandwich. I was sitting in the corner with my mouth salivating and stuff for like ever, bro. That's it, bro? That's all it takes? I already do something like that. You remember this? It's the bro special. Everyone loves the bro special. Bob, come on. You don't think the same way? You're still a stallion, right? Shakabra, remember? That's uber uncalled for. My mom has nothing to do with this. Bro, just tell me this is a dream. Thank you.
My God, ladies and gentlemen, this is very exciting. This is Luke from GCW, and I'm here with Danny Meltzer for this following matchup. I'm very, very excited to be here tonight for G-Man's birthday, and I'm also very excited to see this man for the very first time. We don't have Bane over in GCW. This is the very first time for me to see him live here in action, and I'm so hyped to see what he got in store for us here tonight.
But what is next for Bane? Maybe we'll find out here as he's getting handed a microphone. Pay attention.
It seems as though the first step to reclamation has been taken. At Winter's Lair, I broke the body and spirit of the so-called Panama City Playboy. But such things happen when you recruit a boy against a man. Nonetheless, I have done what I set out to do. I ripped the hope of the Undisputed Era from their clutches and claimed my first prize on the road to what is owed to me. The NXT Championship, which allows me to take what is rightfully mine. And once I do, Mr. Wildcard, you and I shall have a beginning conversation about your purpose here. But as you know, my patience has been very useless by you in your childish days. I promise you, before the end of the year, I will find whatever decrepit home you're hiding in and break you into. With that said, I will show you where I will challenge the current world
champion. Oh, shit!
Cut the music. Cut it.
What are you doing?
I got no idea what you just said, bro. But I get one thing. Your name is Bang.
What?
You're from Spider-Man. You got a belt.
Spider-Man?
And I guess that means you're the dude I gotta beat, bro. People say everyone's scared of you. Even the Fortnite guy, apparently. But I just don't care, bro. Because I'm on a mission. In order to get my friends back, I gotta get my hands on that. The NXT Championship, bro. Put it on the line tonight. Because if Spider-Man can beat you, so can I.
It seems like the crowd is on Matt Riddle's side here. They want to see it.
Can someone please inform him who he just pushed?
Your call is a noble one, Matthew. No, no. But mistaken. But if it's vindication, you see, then I will be glad to make an example of you. The title match is yours. Right here. Right now.
You gotta be kidding me. You gotta be kidding me.
Oh my God, bro. For swear? You're on. Wait, one more thing. Can I invite my friends over to watch?
Of course.
Yes! Jay, Bob, you won't believe the score I just landed. I'm gonna beat Bang and become the NXT champion. And then Moon Cabbage is on me. I bet that scrawny guy can't pull that off.
This guy's an absolute madman, as there's Jay and Silent Bob there.
Bros, I knew you'd come back for me. Can someone get my bros a couple of seats? I want them to have the best
view. Oh my God, could it be? Freshly squeezed, Orange Cassidy has made it to Birthday Bash 22. What the hell is happening right now? Jay and Silent Bob, accompanied by Orange Cassidy, are here to watch Matt Riddle. Let's face it, he's gonna die. Matt Riddle, I will send all the condolences to your family. All your proceeds in this match will go to your wife and kids without a doubt. But Matt doesn't seem to be deterred. He actually seems determined, as this is an impromptu NXT title match right here at Birthday Bash. This isn't scheduled, but it looks like we're gonna have this match right here, right now.
Bell rings and here we go, and Riddle goes after Bane immediately. But Bane counters, throws Riddle off. Oh my God, what a kick to the head of Bane. The knee blocked by Bane, now going for What is he going for? Chokeslam, but oh my gosh, what a counter by Matt Riddle. Right out of the gate, these two going at each other here very, very quickly. And now Bane is trying to fight his way out of this.
I was not expecting this. I am not prepared. I am so scared for Matt Riddle, but look at this. He's still a trooper. He is still fighting with all of his heart as he's holding in that chokehold. But look at Bane, the strength of him just allows him to pry him off as he charges into the corner.
Oh my God, into the corner goes Riddle. And now he's all caught up as Bane gets a vicious kick to the ribs of Riddle there. And now what is he thinking? Strike Riddle out of the way, nicely countered. And on the ground with the kicks in the corner. And one to the head, but Bane catches it, counters. And oh my God, what a slam.
And now, things have grinded to an absolute halt here as Riddle is just getting thrown around by the Liberator.
Now the crowd cheering up Matt Riddle, who's looking for a kick, but Bane counter, sending him into the ropes. But for the Lariat, no, counter by Riddle, into the knee, but now Bane counters, and oh my God, drops Riddle right on the top of his neck.
But look at Bane just absolutely adding insult to injury to Matt Riddle, and Matt Riddle looks towards Jay and Silent Bob, looking towards Orange Cassidy. I think Matt Riddle is starting to get pissed off here. There's the chop, but Riddle just eats that shit. And again, Riddle is possessed. He is a man possessed, and Bane doesn't know what to do as Riddle lays in to Bane's chest with those rapid fire chops. Tries to go for the elbow. Bane able to dodge it. Dragon suplex, no. Matt Riddle lands on his feet. There's the Broton. Rolls back to his feet. Are we going to see another one? There it is. And now Bane's chest has to be compressed as he was able to dodge that moonsault. But look at Riddle, always quick on his feet with that last Broton. But wait a minute. Bane didn't even let the referee get to the floor to count the pin before kicking out.
Now what is he thinking? Maybe Broto sleep here. Bane counters. Goes for the suplex, but Riddle.
Look at Riddle. He smarted his own way. You can call him an idiot. You can call him a dumbass. But one thing you cannot call him is a shit fighter as he has the ankle lock applied. But look at Bane. Bane is one smart cookie as well as he sends Matt Riddle, rolls him out of the ring.
Now what is he thinking? Bane going for a huge dive, but what a strike by Riddle, catching him. Oh my God, what a knee. Right here on the apron. And now what is Riddle thinking? Oh no, looking for Bro Derek on the apron, but Bane counters. And oh my God, what a back suplex onto the ring apron. This has to be it. Riddle is down.
Now he's writhing in pain. Every time Riddle seems to be having some kind of momentum, Bane just stops it.
Crushing the back of Matt Riddle. Oh my God, just that power by Bane. And Riddle, he seems done for, ladies and gentlemen. Now the knee strikes to the midsection there.
Now Bane looking to add some momentum here, trying to gain some momentum as he tries to hit that splash, but look at Matt Riddle, able to dodge out of the way, off the ropes, here comes Riddle, elbow, smack dab in the face of Bane, but he's not done yet. Riddle is a locomotive, oh my God, or could you say a locomotive? I'll stop.
Going for another one, but oh, Bane caught him again.
Oh my God, look at the strength of Bane as he's about to hit that powerbomb. But look at Riddle, grabs the ropes, sends Bane to the outside, crashing onto the floor. Matt Riddle has the advantage once again, and look at Akam and Razor.
Now what is he thinking? A floating bro to the outside.
Takes down Bane, and everyone is fired up, and so is Matt Riddle. What lengths will Matt Riddle be willing to go to get that championship? As he asked for a fist pump, but Jay just looked away. What is going on with this guy?
They don't seem too impressed here. even though Matt Riddle's putting up a great performance here against Bane. Now going onto the top rope. What is he thinking? Top rope, Senton crushes the ribs of Bane into the cover. But oh no, a kick out.
Bane gets the shoulder up once again. And you know what? I'm not surprised. We've seen him take some crazy shit at WinterSlam. So it's going to take a lot more than what Riddle is dishing out. And like I said, it's going to take a lot more than that, as Bane seems to be immune to those kicks. But Riddle is not immune to that one. Oh my God, I felt that in my balls. But look at Riddle hoisted up on Bane's shoulders. Wait a second. Assault driver by Bane. Shades of sick Nick Mondo.
Oh, but Riddle able to kick out.
Bane is in. Oh, God. Oh,
no. This is just hard to watch, ladies and gentlemen.
That was disgusting. And now Bane, yeah, finish him off. Don't do anything else. But look at Riddle. What the hell are you doing, kid? Just stop. Tries to go for the bro to sleep one more time, but Bane able to get out of it once again. Oh my God, sickening headbutt to Riddle, but he bounces off the ropes.
Oh my God, what a knee. But Bane still not down.
Oh my God, discus clothesline. Well, look at Riddle, he's back on his feet. Powerbomb.
Oh my goodness, what is going on here? Knee, is this finally it? Is this finally the moment for Matt Riddle, bro, to sleep? Oh my God, poison rod on counter. This is crazy, ladies and gentlemen. Spear
by Riddle. Bane does not know what the hell to expect here as Riddle hits another spear. Shades of Goldberg. And Riddle is feeling himself. He's got the ripcord. Ripcord knee right to the mush. Riddle, can he hit it? He hits the bro to sleep finally. Now
German
by Riddle. Are we going? Oh my God, are you kidding me?
But how is this man back up after all the punishment he has just taken?
Oh my God! Put some dent on his head, but look at Riddle, he's back up to his feet! No!
Riddle just cannot take the same amount of punishment that Bane can.
Bane doesn't seem to be breaking a sweat here. How the hell is Riddle gonna...
They are friends.
Could this be how? Oh my God! Are we gonna see Blazin? Yeah, give it to him, Jay! He needs it!
Oh no.
What? Where are they going?
Oh no.
They just abandoned Matt Riddle! Oh my God! But watch out, Matt! There's Bane right behind you! You're still in the middle of a match! Bane has him hoisted up!
Oh my God!
Feast your eyes right to the face of Riddle! And I think it's over! It's over.
My goodness, ladies and gentlemen, what a terrible night for Matt Riddle. He gave all he had, but in the end, it was not enough.
So, which one of us do you think is going to become canon first?
Wow, what a match. How do you feel? Let's just go.
Look, Kevin, I made this match with Naito to prove to Dream and every one of those idiots in the crowd that there's only one guy deserving to rule this division. And you're looking at him. Obsessed? Let me tell you something, my no-neck friend. I'm not obsessed with him. I'm exposing him as the fraud champion he is. Think about it, man. Why is it a fact that Dream is a pedophile? It's completely ignored around here. When he was in any other fed, he got released after being exposed, as any sane promoter would rightfully do. But oh no, in this place, it's like the freaking Twilight Zone. Why? Conspiracy. Because with Naito gone, Dream will have no choice but to face up to me and his crimes. And don't question my genius, Kev. Why are you asking me so many questions anyways? Do you think people did nothing but ask questions when it was discovered the Earth was flat? Or that we're all just in a VR? No, they trusted the system. What? What do you mean? Right. Well, I'm off to my match. And if you're done being a Debbie Downer doubter, you are welcome to join me. Alpha Zane, out.
God, look at this. Oh, into the barricade. And now Sammy is just pounding away at the international talent of Tetsuya Naito. Sami Zayn has been in a... Wait, what? What the hell? When did that get there? Was that always there? I don't know, but Sami Zayn is not going to let it distract him as the ref is telling him to get back inside the ring so they can start this match. But Sami Zayn, not paying any attention to any of that, as he's looking to end the career of Tetsuya Naito early here with the brainbuster on the apron. That's the hardest part of the ring. Wait a second. Naito able to counter. Look at this neck breaker onto the apron, onto the side, onto the edge of the ring, rather. But now what's this? Wait, Naito looking for the Stardust Press. Can he hit it? No! Sami Zayn moved out of the way. And in character, Sami is not one to pass up an opportunity when it's given to him. The bell is rung and this match is now official as he tries to go for the Yakuza kick. But look at Naito, able to roll him up for the pin. Can he win it? No. He tried to go for a shocking factor win here. But look at Naito, still on the attack as he sends Sami to the outside. Now what's he thinking? Oh, wait a second, are we going to see a Tope Suicida? No, look at this! Sami able to intercept and take Naito outside of his ring. In his own words, now he's going for his own Tope Cordero, but look at Naito, able to get in the ring, try to get the clothesline. Look at Sami, off the ropes, but look at Naito, notices the opportunity, and hits the wheel kick right to the mush, takes down the Alpha Zane, or the God Slayer, whatever the fuck he wants to call himself. But now look at this, Naito just stomping all over the face of Sami Zayn, the North American champion. He's not looking so great here as he gets the elbow right across the ear by Naito. Now look at this into the corner there. Oh, sickening thud of his back against those turnbuckles. But look at this, wait a second. Oh, what a low down, dirty son of a bitch. Oh my God, the big boot right to the side of the head of Tetsuya Naito. And now Sami is the one who has the advantage here. And now, ooh, the chop right to the chest of Naito. And now Sami looking to add some more damage to the repertoire that is this match. With those stiff elbows, and now dragging him into the corner and hits the chop onto the chest. We know what's coming here. Can he go for the springboard tornado? Oh my God! Tetsuya Naito just shoved Sami Zayn to the outside, but now what the hell is he thinking here? Oh, he's intercepting. Oh, just all over the place as he hits the Tope Suicida. Oh my God, onto the announce table crashes Sami Zayn. And the crowd is fired up as they're wanting to see Tetsuya Naito finally shut the mouth of Sami once and for all. Can he hit this pile driver right in front of the announce team? Paul Heyman and Taz, who are only there for display, by the way. I am the one who's calling the action. Danny Meltzer, the one and only, the great. And now waits. Oh, he tried again for that pile driver, but look at Sami. He was able to counter, and oh my God! You have got to be fucking kidding me. He just killed Tetsuya Naito with the half and half suplex off of the announce table and onto the hard floor. That's it. Naito's got to be done for. And now what's this? Just adding more damage to the... Oh my God, springboard, moonsault. And now, could it be over? No! Tetsuya still gets the shoulder up. And now... not taking any chances here as he's trying to go for that brain bust style, but look, Naito counters, dropping the back of Sami's head onto his knee, off the ropes, jumps, hits the drop kick to the back of the neck. Naito is infamous for targeting the neck and head area of his opponents here, and he's looking to be doing that exact thing with that enziguri. Beautifully placed to the ear of Sami, German suplex drops him right on his neck. And now, what the hell is Naito thinking of doing here off the ropes? Oh, look at Sami, he's back up and he hits the drop kick right to the mush of Tetsuya Naito. And now it's Sami's turn to get into the ropes. And now try to go for the haluma kick, but no. Naito able to dodge and able to block it. And now can we go for the Destino? No, wait a second. Sami, look at the strength, able to block it on his feet. Now Sami revving up for the blue thunder bomb. Beautifully placed there. No, it's still not enough for Tetsuya to just get down and lay for the pin. And now these sickening kicks. Try to go for the clothesline, but look at Tetsuya! Tetsuya Naito! Emerald Fusion drops him right down in center. No! Sami is still in the match. And you gotta be wondering, is the Intercontinental Champion, the Velveteen Dream, watching as the two try to kill each other? I think Naito just tried to go for another Stardust press, but Sami looking to hit a powerbomb. No! Hurricanrana into the corner, face first, into the turnbuckle, the middle turnbuckle to be exact, and Sami is stunned. And now what's Naito thinking here? No! Sami, exploder suplex into the corner! Oh my God. Naito has to be rocked here, and now Sami Zayn not taking any chances, going full throttle, and he hits the Yakuza! Naito eats shit, but He could have gone for the cover right there, but look at Sammy. He's refusing. Oh, no. Don't tell. Wait. Wait a minute. No. Are we going to see it, ladies and gentlemen? Are we going to see it for the first time in FAW history? The Brainbuster on the top rope. Naito's in trouble. He could die now. Able to escape. And Sammy's balls crashed onto the turnbuckle. This could be Naito's opportunity. Now, what the hell is he thinking here? No. No way. No way. Reverse Rana from the top. Somebody check on Sammy. But now, I don't think anyone has the opportunity here. As Naito hits the Destino. Perfectly landed. Is it over? Is it over? No. Wait, did he get it? Did he get it? No. What? Sammy kicked out. How the hell did he kick out? Call Sammy whatever you want. But he truly lives up to his name as Alpha Zeta. They just took the head off of Tetsuya Naito with that vicious clothesline. He tried to go for another Destino, but Sammy wasn't having it. Now, Sammy looking to end this once and for all, saying that the dream is his. Michinoku Driver, now another Destino right off the bat. Tetsuya is looking to win here. And wait a minute, what the hell? It's Kevin Owens. Super kick. Right to the face. What the hell? And now the referee has to call for the bell. What the hell, Kevin? This was a barn burner of a match. Wait, wait, wait. No, 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 no. Oh, my God. Powerbomb onto the apron. Tetsuya is rocked, but now Kevin Owens. Wait a minute. Kevin Owens props him up against the steps. No, 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 no. A halluva kick. Into the steps. Naito's career may be done for. How low is Sami Zayn willing to go to quench his obsession with the Velveteen Dream?
Oh, no! No! Bro!
Expected someone else? You really that stupid, people? Last time we saw Kenny Omega, he was dropped on his ass and kicked out of the show. And Johnny, we haven't seen that hyped up no-seller since October of last year. He needs to change his name from Johnny Wrestling to Johnny No-Show.
Good one, Sammy, good one.
Alright, calm down, incels, just relax. Because you just got something even better. I'm talking the hottest free agent in PickFed today. the Spanish sex god Sammy Guevara. Who else stole the show at SWE's Zdenka 2080? I'll tell you what, since I'm in a good mood today, I'll give all y'all neckbeards one on the house. Oh, and Mr. Wildcard, once I beat the ass of whoever steps in the ring with me, feel free to hit me up.
And it looks like a certain cruiserweight has taken big interest in this open challenge made by Sammy Guevara. Pete Dunne is here. And after his banger of a match with Marty Scurll at Winter Slam, it looks like he's hungry for even more action here tonight.
Pete, 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 glad you could make it to the party, man. But when I said on the house, I didn't mean just any old pipsqueak can walk in my ring. I need someone with more marquee value. You see, the Spanish sex god is in high demand. I'm all the way up here, while you're just down here, mid-card at best. Sorry, Pete, but I don't make the rules. You're just a fossil, man. Keep grinding and maybe you'll have that main attraction type match after all. Till then, make some room for the real main eventers.
He hasn't been here for 5 minutes and I already hate his go. Oh, look at Pete Dunne!
I'm trying not to laugh.
Ring the fucking bell.
And it looks like the match has been made official here, ladies and gentlemen. Sammy Guevara and the Bruiserweight Pete Dunne are going to clash here for the first time ever in FAW Birthday Bash 22. And there goes the bell. And there goes Sammy Guevara crashing and burning after that vicious elbow by Pete Dunne. He ran straight into that. I don't know what Sammy wanted. I don't know what Sammy was expecting, but when you pick a fight with Pete Dunne, you best not miss. And Pete Dunne sure as hell's not going to miss this. Oh, wait, he does! As Sammy Guevara is able to avoid that moonsault off of the top post. But what the hell is this? What the hell? Sammy Guevara taking down Pete Dunne with a move that I didn't even know existed. Sammy Guevara just made one hell of a first impression as he puts the disrespect on Pete Dunne's name, and you might not have wanted to do that, but wait, what the hell? Sammy Guevara with the kick from the heavens there as his agility and speed rivals that of Spider-Man and the Flash, and by that I mean Barry Allen, not fucking, oh no! The Enziguri puts a stop to Sammy Guevara's momentum here by Pete Dunne, and now with his bell rung, Pete Dunne is looking to finish off Sammy Guevara with the X-Plex on the gun. Now stable, but Sammy Guevara able to flip his way out of this one. Once again, the super kick. Able to gain some distance away from the cruiserweight Pete Dunne. And here comes Sammy, trying to go for that senton off of the commentator's table. But look at Pete Dunne. Look at Sammy Guevara. I can't call this shit off of the moonsault from the barricade. Pete Dunne has been taking down once again. Sammy Guevara is 2 for 2, and he feels the energy of this crowd as they have grown to love this man in the span of 2 minutes. Or at least that's what it feels like, as Sammy Guevara is just going tit for tat with an already established veteran of the game, Pete Dunne. But wait a minute, reverse into the barricade goes Dunne. Wait, no, not Dunne. Oh, God! Huge belly-to-belly suplex onto the ground. As Pete Dunne breaks the count away. This is still an official match. This isn't just some brawl. And Sammy Guevara is still feeling the effects of that suplex. And Pete Dunne has now introduced a chair into this matchup. Ladies and gentlemen, don't get me wrong. This is not a no DQ match. So Pete Dunne has to use this chair sparingly. Oh, God. He is not sparing any punishment for Sammy Guevara as he looks to humble him in front of everyone here in attendance at Birthday Bash 22. And now Pete Dunne calling to the fans, calling for their energy like Goku with the spirit bomb. And oh my God! His spirit may have just left his body as Sammy Guevara just hit the knee of the century right to the jaw. And again, taking down Pete Dunne with that huge super kick. And no, don't worry, Sammy, I'm pretty sure he is slumbering. And now, what the hell is Sammy Guevara doing with those steel steps? What the hell is he doing now? Taking a roundabout all the way around the ring. And now he's building momentum to destruct Flipside Khan! Takes down Pete Dunne with the chair! Are you kidding me? Holy shit indeed, as Sammy Guevara is as sure as hell making his name known here amongst the FAW believers, but there goes Pete Dunne. Forever, the high IQ shining through in this match by the Bruiserweight. And now he's looking to get an opportunity to hit this super collect. Oh no! Sammy Guevara raking the eyes of Pete Dunne, and he knocks him down from the top. And now, this is not where Pete Dunne wants to be. Sammy Guevara is a master of the flyers, but look at this. Pete Dunne able to dodge that. Now, Sammy Guevara back to his feet. Dunne able to dodge that kick, but he's not able to dodge the second one as he is stunned. And he is forced to retreat into the corner.
Where are you going, you fool?
Sammy Guevara put his heart and soul into that kick as Pete Dunne is no doubt seeing stars here. As we may just be seeing the birth of a brand new star as Sammy Guevara hops up the top with the moonsault. Pete Dunne able to dodge that one. Oh, another moonsault. Pete Dunne able to avoid again. Shooting star press into the armbar. Armbar beautifully applied. What a counter by Pete Dunne. As Sammy Guevara, the Spanish six god, is in deep, deep trouble. He's in jeopardy of tapping here, but look at the strength. He's fighting to get to the ropes, and he does, to the dismay of everyone here in the arena of Birthday Bash 22. And now Pete Dunne, using the ref's count to his advantage, using every last second he can to put the damage onto Sammy Guevara's arm. And now Pete Dunne, he's full of fury, but he isn't stupid. As he hits that vicious elbow right to Sammy Guevara. But look at this, Sammy Guevara pulling through right back at you, Pete. That huge elbow by Sammy. Now, what's this? Sammy Guevara off the ropes, runs into the end of Curry by Pete Dunne. The Bruiserweight is in fuego, but look at this. Oh, God. Sammy Guevara's digits may be in jeopardy. Oh, no. I've never seen anyone counter it like that. Oh, super kick. Super kick right across the bush. Oh, my God. These two just trading haymakers. Huge pump knee right to the chin. And now Pete Dunne. Oh, my God. What a headbutt. Crashing his head onto the jaw of Sammy Guevara. But Sammy Guevara with the standing Spanish fly right into the center of the ring. And it's still not enough to take down Pete Dunne. Both of these men are at absolute war. It is awesome indeed, as both these men don't know what to do with each other. And now Sammy Guevara. Oh, are you kidding me? That was completely uncalled for, and that only serves to piss off Pete Dunne. This man has a fucking death wish. And there goes Pete Dunne with the fury. The flurry of punches, the vicious bear has been unleashed. And now the ref trying to put a stop to this. You know, I don't want to be biased, but I really want to. Oh, God! Huge knee off the distraction from the ref. And now Irish Whip into the corner. Pete Dunne makes the best out of a bad situation, but so does fucking Guevara. Look at this moonsault into the deadlift German suplex. Oh my God, what a maneuver, but it's still not enough to take down Pete Dunne. Wait, Sammy Guevara up on his feet. Oh, super kick from hell. This could be it. You gotta be kidding me. How is that not it? I hate Sammy Guevara, but Jesus Christ, even I'm as shocked as he is. What does he have to do? And I think he's got an idea. That GTS Burning Hammer combination about to apply here. No, it doesn't. That Pete Dunne has the digits. Oh, my God. Did you just hear the snap of his fingers? Guevara's hand has been compromised as Pete Dunne lands that vicious rebound German suplex. Sammy Guevara is in deep trouble. Oh, my God. As if that weren't enough, Pete Dunne is just punishing this young man as he kicks his head off. Pete Dunne is now on a roll here as he's about to make Sammy Guevara suffer with that X-Plex into the armbar. Great transition. Fantastic transition by Pete Dunne as he's targeting that arm. Once again, is Sammy Guevara going to tap? No, he absolutely refuses. He wants people to remember his name, and he doesn't want to lose his debut match here at FAW. As you can see, the strength of Guevara, but look at this. Whoa, whoa, dodging, bobbing and weaving, weaving and bobbing. And now Pete Dunne, wait, he faked him out. Oh! That's it, he is swamped. And now, Pete Dunne looking to pick up the scraps and take out the garbage that is Sammy Guevara. About to hit the bitter end here, it's gonna connect. Oh, wait, what? A variation into the tombstone pile driver.
by Pete Dunne, and it's over. What a match, and what a performance by Sammy Guevara. But look at this, Pete Dunne is not satisfied here. Wait, you already won the match, Pete. Oh my God, he's stopping a butthole in the face of Sammy Guevara. He wants to make sure he never forgets this night. And Pete Dunne stating his claim for his territory here in FAW.
Just a quick ad here, people. I want to give a very special thanks and shout out to the incredibly talented artist who made this show as unique as possible. These guys have been responsible for the jaw-dropping art you've seen in my more recent videos. Each of their styles are so unique and beautiful, they easily bring the characters and stories of FAW to life. If you like what you've seen from these guys, go on and give them a follow to support their future work. And let's not forget about the wonderful voiceover artists who took things to the next level. I'll make sure to link their Fiverr pages down below so you can support their work over there as well. I can't express how grateful I am to all of these gifted people, and I hope you're excited to see more from them as I am. All right, let's get back to the action.
And ladies and gentlemen, we are back, and it is time for our main event of the evening. Film Workers and Mike Awesome are set to clash.
Introducing first, beyond the grave, he is the god of death, Film Workers!
There are no men who can say that they have conquered this business like Film Workers. Film has battled the likes of Rob Van Dam, humiliated and violated him at Maximum Carnage. He almost killed Dean Ambrose with a boulder at Zombieland. And he beat Roman Reigns at WinterSlam. But tonight, can he take on Mike Awesome?
Ladies and gentlemen.
What? Wait, it's Paul Heyman.
My name is Paul Heyman.
Wow, how typical. Oh, Jesus, Mill's gonna kill him. Mill's gonna kill him. Who the hell could it possibly
you
be?
You think you know me?
What? What? No! No, there's no way!
On this day,
we take the photo from Toronto, Ontario, Canada, the rated R superstar, A!
I cannot believe my eyes here, ladies and gentlemen! The rated R superstar, A! Because now we're going to witness an instant classic. But here comes Film Workers with the Reaper's Trident from out of nowhere. Holy shit. And just like that, the tables have been turned. And Edge might just be regretting his decision to come here. As the crowd are definitely not happy with Film Workers' actions here. As he's already getting the weapons out. He's not a fan of just foreplay. He's not a fan of bullshitting around, and there's the glass pane, and I am having complete PTSD as we speak, ladies and gentlemen. This is our main event of Birthday Bash 22. After this, G-Man will make his appearance
for the first time since WinterSlam. But now, I'm not even sure he's going to be able to get into an arena. As Milmuertes is surely planning on tearing this entire establishment down using the body of Edge. Jesus. Now he's just manhandling him. Oh, wait a second. Oh, my God. Oh, back first into the ring post. Ghost Edge. And you can see the concern on our referee, Chris Masters' face as Milmuertes. No, 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 no. Wait a second. No, the powerbomb through the glass pane. No, I can't watch. Oh, Edge. Edge able to escape. Able to escape out of it. Oh, just a good measure. Trying to get away from Milmuertes as fast as possible. But Milmuertes following through like a slasher from a slasher flick. And the dropkick connects, but it does absolutely nothing to Milmuertes. Now, wait a second. Here he comes like a charging bull, but Edge able to get out of the way. Milmuertes on the outside. He's vulnerable. Could Edge be thinking about the spear through the glass pane? No, don't tell me. Oh, Milmuertes. Able to save his own life. Ironic coming from a man of 1,000 deaths. He's coming to the sky still. Edge able to dodge out of the way. Boy, wait. He could be looking for a spear now. The choke. Chokeslam position. No, he forces him into the corner. Milmuertes is just an uncaged animal here as he's looking to take the head off of Edge with these tremendous, vicious lariats into the corner. Oh, my God. I don't know how much more Edge can take as Milmuertes is still intrigued with that glass pane. What the hell could he be thinking of doing here? And now he's just carrying around Edge as if he was just a piece of trash. Just complete, just with complete ease. He's picking up Edge, no, from the powerbomb on the top of the glass pane. No, this will surely kill Edge. But Edge fighting back. Oh, no, Hurricane Rana through the glass pane. Milmuertes falls from the heavens down to hell. Jesus Christ, I've never seen that in my life. Yes, I have. Who am I kidding? But this is still horrifying. All the same as Milmuertes. How the hell is he still moving after that? Edge is looking to change that back here. Wait a second. Oh, my God. Tope Cone Halo. Oh, no. Milmuertes, look at the strength of this beast. Powerbomb up to the steel stage. Jesus Christ. Is there anything Milmuertes can't handle? Okay, sure, why not? Another glass pane? This is birthday bash after all. Oh my God, what a boot right to the face just for added measure. Milmuertes is putting on the punishment, not letting Edge get any bearings on his life here. Milmuertes continuing the punishment. Oh my God, he just drives him into the steel steps. It's so easy for Milmuertes. This just comes second nature to him. Pain and suffering is all he knows. Ever since he was a little boy trapped in that earthquake in Mexico. And now, wait a second. Oh, wait, but no! Oh, my God, where the hell did he get a baseball bat from? Clocking it onto the side of the head of Milmuertes. And this could be the advantage that Edge needs. And now, he's going to the top. What the hell is he thinking of doing here? Oh, my God, from the top, using a baseball bat! Driving it into the throat, but Milmuertes isn't going to give up that easily. And now Edge not wasting any time, trying to put more punishment onto Mil, using the bat to strangle him. And now Milmuertes, oh my God, sometimes it just doesn't matter. It just doesn't matter when you're facing a man as strong as Milmuertes. But Edge still on the attack here as he sends Milmuertes tumbling to the outside using that bat. Edge has to keep the advantage. He can't let Milmuertes breathe here. He has to keep on the offensive. And he might just be doing that same thing from the top. But no! Milmuertes able to catch him into the chokeslam position once again. And now, oh my God, lava lamp chokeslam onto the announce table. Right in front of Taz and Paul Heyman, who move out of the way. And Milmuertes is cleaning house. Paul Heyman looking with absolute concern. You know damn well he's wondering what would happen if Milmuertes were to actually face Mike Awesome as he was scheduled to. As Edge was able to get out of this predicament, was off for the flatliner on the announce table, but Edge with that boot sends Milmuertes packing. And now Edge, wait a second, looking for the crossbody off the announce table, but look at the strength of Milmuertes. Easily catches him, and now he's just having his way with the body of Edge as he just tosses him into the ring post. Jesus H. Christ.
There are no words to describe the brutality of Mil Muertes. Edge was having a good run, but you know, sometimes Mil Muertes just knows exactly what to do as he can look into the eyes of death itself as Edge helplessly tries to crawl away, but Mil Muertes is not having any of it. Those vicious right hands and no! Oh my God! Jesus, now turn the camera away. I can't watch this. He's just grinding his face into the broken glass with his boot. The disrespect knows no limits when it comes to Mil Muertes in a death match. And now Mil dragging Edge back inside the ring. And now Edge trying to get his bearings back. Oh my God, just gets the steel chair for his troubles right across the dome. Mil Muertes just relishes in this pain and suffering. He loves it. I'm pretty sure he gets off on it as Paul Heyman is looking with great interest. And now what the hell can he be doing? Oh God, no, he's biting his flesh from his face! How disgusting is this man? Mil Muertes having the taste of blood coursing through his mouth. And you can be pretty damn sure he loves every second of it. And now he has the thumbtacks, because why the hell not? And oh my God, for added measure, just bashing the back of Edge with that steel bucket. And now could he be looking for the tombstone piledriver on the thumbtacks? Edge escapes! Edge-o-matic onto the thumbtacks! And now the cover! No, it's still not enough to take down Mil Muertes. That could have been Edge's final gasp of hope in this matchup. It's Mil Muertes. He's hurting after that thump, after those thumbtacks pierced his flesh. And now wait a minute, Edge charging through. Could he be hitting the spear through the barricade? This is the rated R superstar we've all come to love. The ultimate opportunist, as he took the opportunity to cut Mil Muertes in half through that barricade. But does he have the strength to continue this fight? Mil Muertes has put a lot of damage on Edge's body. But Edge, looking to return the favor, as he's signaling for the spear. Could it happen? Could we be witnessing the end of Mil Muertes' winning streak here at FAW? The Mil Muertes, oh, the power slam, just manhandled him. And now Mil Muertes releasing all the frustration in his cold black heart. Bashing his head onto the ring, Mil Muertes may have just gotten some distance, may have just gotten some time to get his breath back into his system. And now Edge might be in trouble. Reaper's trying to come in right through, but no, Edge with the counter, the guillotine, takes down Mil Muertes. That's one way to take down the beast. But can Edge make Mil Muertes tap out or pass out? He's gonna have to. He needs to pray to Jesus Christ himself that Mil Muertes will fall asleep here. But maybe this isn't the way it's gonna happen. And oh my God, driving him through the corner. Oh, and again, over and over, Mil Muertes desperately trying to fight out of this hole. But Edge is still holding on to dear life, telling him that he'll never let go until Mil Muertes falls for the final time here in FAW. Oh my God, through the barricade! That is one way to get out of a submission hold, all right. Mil Muertes just does not give a fuck about his well-being or anyone else's. And Edge feeling the after effects of that tragic and travesty. And what the hell? Like a slasher flick. Mil Muertes has found a fucking knife. What the hell is he thinking I'm doing here? I'm having flashbacks to Maximum Carnage, where he just skewered Rob Van Dam's head with that kitchen knife, and he might be looking to do the same thing to Edge. Oh my God, no! No! Edge able to escape out of it, but Mil Muertes is not done like Jason Voorhees, coming from the depths of hell! Oh no! No, no, please don't say, please don't tell me this is gonna happen! Oh! The hot shot! Edge able to get out of the way, and now Edge looking for the spear, and then the table's right there! No! My goodness gracious, Mil Muertes! Able to get out of that. Able to think one step ahead here. As he now has Edge right where he wants him. The knife is held up, no! Oh my God, please don't. Don't do it, Mil. Edge fighting with his life as he hits him where the sun don't shine. That might be the only way out of that situation. As Edge hits the execution through the two tables. There are no words. cards! Like the inferior commentator Mauro Ranallo loves to say, Mama fucking Mia. And Edge, he could end this fight right now. He has Mill on the ropes. Just do it, Edge. Just end this. What the hell are you doing? Oh, it's not enough for him. Edge is starting to see red. I can see it in his eyes. That crazed look that I only know from a couple of times in his career. Edge has the chair. What the hell is he thinking? Oh, my God. All across the dome of Mil Muertes goes to steel. And now Edge has lost his marbles as he's just unleashing a frenzy of chair shots to the back of the man of a thousand deaths. And Mil Muertes might just be dying a thousand deaths when he's facing off against the rated R superstar. What the hell could... Wait, no. A concerto might just be in order here in this matchup, but where the hell is Edge going? Where the hell is he going? Where'd he go? Oh, man, the carnage in this match is just, it's just too much to describe. What the hell? Where the hell did he get a ladder from? And how did he set it up in the audience? Wait, no, Edge, don't do it! Oh, my God, my super concerto from the top of the ladder! Edge risking it all to take down this beast of a man in Mil Muertes! And he might just be doing the trick as everyone here are in shock and awe over what they've just seen. Edge is known to risk everything, life and limb, to get the win here. We saw what he did to Mick Foley at WrestleMania 22 in the WWE. But this is FAW. And when you're facing off with Mil Muertes, you got to bring your A game. And you know what? I think the rated R superstar has done it. What the hell? He kicked out! Mil Muertes is... He's still in the match! Edge is beside himself! And Mil Muertes rises from the ashes! You just can't kill what's already dead! This is absolutely unbelievable! What the hell do you have to do to take down Mil Muertes? And these boots are just mosquito bites to this man! As Edge desperately tries to take down Mil Muertes with these huge boots, but Mil Muertes caught him, and now he caught Edge into the flatliner! And that just might do it for this matchup. Edge is done. And now Mil Muertes, he could go for the cover. Wait, what's he doing? What the hell is Mil Muertes thinking of? He's got the chair, and now, what the hell? Oh no, oh God! He's looking to pilmanize the neck. You know the history of the neck of Edge. Edge has a bad neck. He's been hunting him for his whole life here in wrestling. No, 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 no. Oh, my goodness gracious. He just severed his spine from his skull and his body. And Mil Muertes is the winner.
Here is your winner, Mil Muertes.
Words cannot describe the carnage and the brutality that Mil Muertes brings to the table when it comes to these matches. And this is just a warning here. If you're at the point, what's going on? What's going on? What the hell? Who's that up on the Titan truck? And what the, could it be? It's Darby Allin! Darby Allin is here! And he's looking onto Mil Muertes with great interest!
You are simply gorgeous.
Hey, it's me, Goku!
I sure hope so.
I used to be champion.
Sorry about that? Really? Nothing with an ounce of alcohol? Looks good. I shouldn't be here. This was a mistake. No, Sonya said I needed to do this. I can't stay cooped up in that room forever. She's right. I have to do something about it. Have fun. At his birthday party. God. I just need a drink. What?
No, you are too kind. The only people who deserve this were the children back in Mexico. The orphans, they needed us, and we stopped at nothing to honor them. With these tag team championships, we can support the monastery and keep the children healthy and with full bellies. Escaleto, hold these for me. I feel so happy, I could cry like a girl. But instead, I will serenade this moment with a song! Children, this is perfect. This is for the children I fight for. And this special lady who has made a vow of celibacy. This song is called Forbidden Nectar.
My love is like the nectar from a fruit which is forbidden, and in my heart is hidden all the muscles of my love. When you perchance to see my haunches, like a stallion they are tight.
Mandy? You came.
I was just... I was in town and I thought I'd stop by to get a few drinks. But this is your party, after all.
I can go bring some if you... Wait. What's that supposed to mean? I can drink a little bit and you know that.
Oh, I know you drink a little bit, all right. You're always afraid of getting shit-faced off of a sip. A sip!
Oh my god. Look, I brought some here when this whole shindig got started, but Hangman drank it all. It's not my fault. See?
Right. Well, when you invite an alcoholic, it might be best to get enough inventory.
Come on, I didn't invite anyone. The boss set this whole thing up and I didn't even want it.
Why not?
The only reason this thing is even going on is in celebration of the match at Winter Slam.
Yeah, I saw.
I really wish you didn't. That wasn't me, Mandy. That's not who I am, and it took sitting in that hospital bed all alone for me to realize that. Sometimes I wish I had died that night fighting Pentagon. Not because I would have died happy knowing I went out like a warrior or some bullshit like that, but because I didn't want to see what I had become after the fact. But now, I'm here, whether I like it or not. And you know what? If I had known that I'd actually have the chance to see you again, it would have made the time sitting in that ER a hell of a lot more pleasant. Mandy, I know it wasn't easy for you to come here. I can see it in your eyes as you look at me. And I don't expect you to just... act like what happened didn't happen, but I've prayed so many nights away just to get the chance to let you know. I'm so sorry for what I did to you. And if you'd let me, I want to do everything I can to make it up to you. Mandy! Oh, God, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to... I mean, I shouldn't have...
Get away from me! Get away!
Mandy, wait!
Can't force it, son. Come on, it's time to get out there.
I don't think I can anymore.
I'll go with you. Can't keep the people waiting for too long now.
Ladies and gentlemen, Luke from GCW back here. Danny had to run backstage to catering to stuff his face with some cake because for sure, catering is going to be very empty because we're expecting this man right here for his birthday, the birthday bash of G-Man. Here he comes.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the birthday boy, G-Man!
Everybody has been talking about the match he had with Penta. And now he is back here tonight at the birthday bash. And to be honest, I'm also here to see G-Man. As you have heard, we would love to see him in GCW. And I'm just looking forward to see what he has to say about the future of his career here tonight.
I thank you all for coming. I really, really appreciate it. For months, I was really unsure of what to do with all of this. With my life, with pro wrestling. Truth be told, I was offered a main event spot in this show. Me versus Okada was an idea. I turned it down. It sucks, I know, but... as much as I love this business, I'm having a real tough time seeing how it loves me back. I know there's you guys, and I'm grateful, but the man who you want to see, the guy from WinterSlam, that's not me. I know that's not what you wanted to hear, but it's the truth. Being that guy took everything from me. Everything. I've tried to get it back. I've tried to be better, but it wasn't. I can't do this. I'm sorry, everyone. I'm sorry. Drive home safe.
Oh no, this definitely... Who is this? And oh my god! This is... could it be? It's Brahma Bull, SWE's own monster from the south. The former SWE champion is here.
G-Man! Let me tell you something, Red Beast. You ain't gonna go out like that. Not on my watch. These people, they pay good money to see you. And you're just gonna walk out on them?
Brahma, look, man, I just wanna go home. So please, just...
Now hold on there, Rev Dude, I ain't finished. Tonight's supposed to be a night people ain't never gonna forget. And I came out here to tell you there's only one way to make that happen. G-Man! I won't face
and you. Oh my god! What a huge match would this be?
I wish you a happy birthday! This is your special day. And on any other day, I would have killed. But on this night, it's time for a party! So everyone in the back, get Hey, Jimbo!
But... Where's everybody? Come on, this is G-Man's birthday!
Come out!
Come on out here!
Brahma, you really don't need...
It seems to me that y'all forgot who I am! I'm Brahma Boo! The last time I checked... Hold on, G-Man, get me out. Look to your left, look to your right, look up, look over there. I kill people! That's exactly what I'm gonna do if y'all don't get out here! That's up to Rabbit Beef!
Oh, thank God, there! Everybody comes! And oh my God, this is filling up here very, very quickly! Oh my goodness! This is insane, ladies and gentlemen! And oh, there's Bo Dallas giving the cake to G-Man! This is awesome!
For the coup de grace, happy birthday to you, happy birthday to you, happy birthday to G-Man, happy birthday to you.
Thanks, guys. I needed that.
Good. Now get back to your people, Red Beef.
What a beautiful moment here tonight. This is exactly what we needed. This is what G-Man needed. This is awesome.
All right. After that performance, I think I'll be just fine. And now that I think about it, about what to do, about my future in this industry.
Oh no! It's Santana and Ortiz! What are they doing out here? This is just uncalled for, ladies and gentlemen. Oh no! I mean, I am just disgusted seeing this here. Oh no. Now Ortiz got a table. I thought we had a happy ending here, but it's getting ruined by LAX. And no, now what are they planning? Oh my God, pile driver right on top of the head of G-Man. And he might still be hurting after that war he went through with Penta. Oh no. This is his birthday, goddammit! And now what are they calling for? Why is there nobody coming out to save G-Man here, ladies and gentlemen? I have no clue, but oh no. Oh no! Through the table, my goodness! My goodness, this is just uncalled for. I am so upset, ladies and gentlemen. I am livid here.